This is the access road to Mills Creek Reservoir, and I have spent hundreds of hours out here with Brandy, but this is the first time I've brought Sheila here. This past summer we had a terrible infestation of ticks in this area, and it just wasn't worth all the ticks we'd pick up if we came here. And I forgot how beautiful this area is when the snow is melting and the water is running alongside the road. Here's the road that crosses in front of the end of, I think this is it, crosses the trailer, crosses in front of Turkey Pen Ridge, which is just beginning to build over here. It's the ridge on the left side of the reservoir. I don't know the name of this one over on the right side. But this is about a 2-mile access road that's gated, so we don't have to worry about traffic. And it's a very open forest because a few years ago they set fire to it. Everything is blackened. Meant to have a controlled burn, and I think it did. But the burn was either started or stopped right along this road, so that side has lots of char, and this side doesn't. Now you can see sort of how thick it would have been before the burn. And now it's growing up thorns and stuff, but a lot of the trees are standing dead from the fire. It must have been at least 5 years ago, because I've been out here that long. The only problem is if you walk through that woods, you come out looking like a coal miner, because you brush against all the blackened trees. Behind this little field is an alternate trail that comes out down very near the parking place at the end of this road. Brandy used to always run over there. You need a drink. We'll look at the fields on the way home. We're going to go up the road now, make some time while we're going uphill. I was wrong about that branch. Here's the road that goes in front of Turkey Pen. You can see the pine trees sticking up on the top of the beginnings of Turkey Pen Ridge there. This is the one that goes right in front of it. That means we're less than a half a mile from the dam, and we're going to start climbing pretty soon to get up over the rise where the dam is. There's a natural sandstone formation there that had a narrow cut, and they built the dam over the cut and use the sandstone formation as the emergency spillway. I'll take some pictures of that, because it's pretty impressive where water has washed over it and moved some pretty big hunks of sandstone. We've arrived up at the dam, and here is the sandstone formation that forms the natural emergency spillway, although you can see quite a bit of it has washed out. They must have had some real high water here at one time. Careful. We go down this side, we can climb down like giant steps. And we'll do that on the way back. But we saw a big brown dog up here, and it stared at us for a minute or two and then took off back up the hill. So somebody's probably up here with a dog, but it wasn't confident enough to approach us. So we're gonna go over the spillway here and over the front side of the dam and see if we can see if somebody has it up here. Or if it's alone. I think somebody's like they've about emptied this reservoir. It's only got about a quarter of its original volume. Last time I was here, a couple of years ago, the water was clear over here somewhere. So we're going to get to go down and walk on the bottom. Go down and see the water. Let's go down here and see the water. The rust line on this normal spillway level, but there isn't any water spilling through this part. I hear water spilling somewhere. There must be another opening down here at the bottom of the dam. Boy, look at the rust on this. There's a slide valve, a big round valve, behind a rebar guard, but it's all rusted into immobility. That's the screw jack up there. It pulls that up and down, but it's all rusted beyond recognition. That may be why this is drained. And the normal spillway goes up through there. Stop jumping on me. Well, that looks like another entry, or maybe just a piece of junk with a dead deer on it. And down here at the water, looks like the drain. And the water's swirling towards it, so I guess that's where the water is going out now. And that's why it has that level. They've dumped it all the way down to the bottom. And based on the ice, I'd say it's been here a while. Boy, it sure looks different with the water down 40 or 50 feet. I'd have been 12 feet underwater standing here a couple years ago. And all this grassy stuff has evidently been exposed for a couple of years to grow grass. We'll go out here and get started on the farm. See where we can go. There's got to be ice water. There's ice on it right over there. Is that cold water? I bet. Let's go back here and walk in the grass a little bit. Oh, it's soft and mushy. Guess who's getting dirty? Just a spray of mud flies. New thing to learn how to walk on. Moldy old grass. Well, it looks like in the couple years that this has been empty, grass has grown awful enthusiastically. Maybe they planted it to cut down on erosion. I have made it back along to the back before, but I can't remember exactly how I got there. If there's a trail up on this side, I think maybe there's a trail. You want to go up and look for a road? Let's do that. This is a very dirty girl. This is just a big marsh now. A soft sediments that have settled in here for who knows how long, 40 years maybe. And it's just soup underneath grass. I gotta find a place to get across this spot. She's already dunked in it a couple times and rolled around and stuff. This is a girl that needs a bath somewhere, either on the way home or at home. Okay, I'm going to go up and look for a road. This must have been the trail that I got back to the back of this reservoir before. So that's a nice big boulder down there, below water. bird is giving us hell. This is about the same as the path along Coles Run Reservoir, fishing trail. Too rough for me to walk on and hold a camera though. Yeah, I would say this emergency spillway has definitely had a few emergencies. Badly eroded. We just climbed down over that, and boy, quite rugged. Very big steps.